His research topics, such as taxation, unemployment, and education, have been widely cited in the media and in congressional testimony. Dr. Chetty has been named one of the top young economists in the world by the New York Times and The Economist magazine. He received his PhD from Harvard in 2003 and is one of the youngest tenured professors in the university's history. And of course, we all want to congratulate him on his recent naming to be a MacArthur Fellow for 2012. Raj Chetty.
Thank you very much for having me. I'm really delighted to be here, and I'm sorry that I got the time a little bit off, so I got here a little bit late. So I'm going to talk today about some recent work that I and my colleagues have been doing on the long-term impacts of teachers, and I think broadly, as you'll all see, this is just a testament to the importance of the great work that you all are doing and how important it all is. We sort of just have the statistical evidence documenting how important teachers actually are. So let me dive in and tell you about what we've been studying. So broadly, what we're interested in is understanding the long-term impacts of teachers on students. And in particular, how we can help teachers maximize their impacts on students, because after all, that's the goal of education. And so there are various policies that are frequently discussed, such as potentially providing better training, perhaps higher pay, providing feedback on performance, or other types of policy tools. And these are central questions not only for education policy, but also from an economist's perspective for economic growth. Because as we know, the US seems to be falling behind other countries, particularly in educational achievement. And many economists think that this is a fundamental factor in economic growth and inequality. Now, despite their central importance, we actually know relatively little about these questions. And that's primarily because of a lack of data linking teachers to students over time. So in particular, what you need in order to be able to study the impacts of, say, teachers in third grade on how kids are doing when they're 25 years old is you have to have data that allows you to track a large group of kids over a 20-year period, right? Which is actually a very difficult thing to accomplish using standard surveys and other data resources that social scientists use. So in our recent work, what our research group has done is that we've written two papers studying these questions, and the key innovation from a data point of view is that we link administrative records from school districts, like databases that tell you which teachers a student had, what their test scores were, which classes they took, and so forth, to administrative tax and social security records, which allow us to see these same students' outcomes when they're adults. So these are outcomes like their earnings, which college they attend, whether they had a teenage birth or not, and a broad spectrum of other outcomes that we might ultimately